So now let's talk about the history of the right to life or right to die. Euthanasia is derived from a Greek word that means dying well or good health. The concept of the right to die is not new to the global world. History has seen it in the times of the Roman and the Greeks when people help another person to die easily or to put them to death when needed. For example, in the city of Crete, if a child takes birth with a disability, he or she was killed. In various holy books like the Bible, the Quran and the Vedas, there are mentions of suicide or self-annihilation. When we talk about India, we can see various examples from the Vedic ages where people applied their right to die based on their religious beliefs. In Hindus, there are two perspectives of this issue. According to the first perspective, the doctor who withdraws the life-supporting system of a patient, even on their wishes, should not accept the request as it leads to the death of the person, which according to them is the unnatural death of the person. Another set of people believe that the practice of euthanasia is against the principle of ahimsa, therefore it should be avoided. However, this is the third set of people also who consider euthanasia a good practice, as they believe that ending someone's life who is in pain is an act of good deed